Do kids need carbs to grow? I've been hearing a few questions from people asking me, hey, I would love to put my type 1 diabetic child on a low-carb diet, but I'm so worried because I heard from my doctor that my kids need carbs to grow. And I'm here to tell you that this is a myth. It is not true at all, not substantiated by any real evidence that kids need carbohydrates to grow. At least not from your diet. Now today what we're going to do is we're going to go into this myth, explain why it's wrong, explain where it comes from, and hopefully put you at ease and make you aware that carbs are not essential for growth, or for many things for that matter. To start, where does this myth that kids need carbs to grow come from? You'll see a lot of doctors peddle this kind of information, especially if you're on a low-carb diet, or you put your kid on a low-carb diet, you bring him to the doctor, and they'll fight back and push back against you, saying, your kid's not going to grow if you do that. Where does that come from? Now, I'm no doctor myself, right? But I do have a few theories as to why they talk about this. First is that there actually are some studies that seem to show that low-carb reduces growth, although that's not really the case. These studies focus on epileptic children that get put on a medically ketogenic diet. Now, ketogenic, keto, low carb, all of these kind of words are put together under the same bucket, but in fact, there is a huge difference between a medically ketogenic diet, the one they put these epileptic kids on, and the kind of low carb diet that I recommend. In these studies, they looked at epileptic kids that were put on a ketogenic diet, looked at their growth and so on, and what they found, not in a lot of them, but in some of them, the reviews are actually mixed. In some of them, they found reduced growth. But the thing is, these medically ketogenic diets were a lot different than the kind of low-carb approach that I recommend. See, these kind of diets, what they do is, it's low in carbs, sure, but it's also low in protein. Typically, these medically ketogenic diets were having fat be 90% of all of the energy intake and protein only at 7%. That is a very low protein diet. What you end up with here is a very high fat, very low carb, but also very low protein approach. And that is not what I recommend at all. Instead, what I recommend, what Dr. Bernstein recommend, what all of these type 1 diabetic low carb enthusiasts recommend is a low carb, high protein diet. One that emphasizes protein. That is why you see me emphasize meats so often, because that protein is what is essential for growth. And these kids in these epileptic studies end up with less growth, not because of the carbs, but because they don't get enough protein. They often are getting less than 1 kilogram per gram of body weight of protein, and that is less than average non-growing adults. You need a lot more protein than that, especially if you're a kid or if you're an athlete, to get the growth you need. There's a reason that meat is associated with growth, with muscle, because that's what it gives you. That protein is essential for growth, and you need it on a low-carb diet, especially in order to maintain that growth. For those epileptic kids, the doctors will think, well, it was the low-carb that made them not grow right, but actually it was the low protein. So be sure to keep that protein up. Now, the second reason they might say this is because, well, insulin is the growth hormone, right? Insulin makes you store fat, it helps stimulate growth, and so on. And I would assume they might think that because carbs means more insulin, and more insulin means more growth, then you need carbs for that growth. But that's not logically so, because even on a low-carb diet, you still use some insulin. I'm practically zero carb right now myself. I still eat some carbs, you know, to correct a low blood sugar, but for the most part, almost all my energy comes from fat and protein, and yet despite that, I still have to take insulin. Most diabetics do, unless you have insulin already running through your body. No matter what you eat, you're going to need some insulin. And that insulin, as long as it's adequate, as long as it's enough to fulfill your needs and keep your blood sugar at a healthy normal range, is going to be the insulin you need to grow. You don't need industrial amounts of insulin from an industrial amount of carbs to grow. What you need is just adequate insulin, and you'll get that from a low-carb, high-protein approach, as long as you manage it properly. And of course, it's wrong for the reasons I explain. Those reasons they give are debunked. It's not true that low carb from epileptic ketogenic diets causes low growth. It's the lack of protein. And it's not true that low insulin causes lack of growth. In fact, it's the opposite. What really causes a lack of growth in diabetic children, ironically, isn't low carb, it's bad blood sugar. There have been multiple studies done showing that type 1 diabetic children end up shorter than their non-diabetic peers. Why? It's because their blood sugar is out of whack. And get this, the stunted growth is linked directly to their HbA1c. So the higher the A1c, the lower the growth. Crazy how that works, huh? The same doctor's out telling you that, oh, your kid's HbA1c is great, but, oh, their low carbs are not going to grow right. Are the same ones ignoring the fact that the higher HbA1c is what's actually been proven to stunt your growth? I mean, look at me, for example. I've had diabetes for over 14 years, since I was just a kid. And get this, like most diabetics, I didn't take very good care of it. And look at me now. I'm 25 years old. I look 12. I am absolutely the shortest male adult in my entire family. Now, could it be a coincidence that I'm the shortest person in my family? Maybe. But you know what? Given the evidence that higher blood sugar is correlated to less growth in type 1 diabetic children, and given the fact that I'm just so happen to be one of the shortest people in my family, makes me think that maybe it wasn't a lack of carbs, but my high blood sugars caused by high carb dieting that stunted my growth. So if you're worried about growth in your children, don't worry about not giving them enough carbs. It's that high carb diet, those high blood sugars resulting from it, that leads to the stunted growth. If you want your kids to grow healthy and strong, give them a low carb diet. Give them healthy blood sugars, and that way they'll thrive. And there's evidence of this too. In the recent study that came out observing type 1 diabetics following the Bernstein approach, following the kind of approach I recommend, what they found was that these type 1 diabetics had amazing A1Cs, plus or minus 0.5, around 5.5 A1C, so between 5 and 6 typically. That's amazing for children, way below the average and way closer to normal. And get this, despite the fact that they were all eating a very low-carb diet, they all had exceptional growth at the average level compared to their non-diabetic peers, which other diabetics can't compare to. Isn't that amazing? And you mean you go into these groups like type 1 grit and you actually see it for yourself. You see these kids, such as, you know, R.D. Dykeman's kid, growing fantastically despite being on low carb for many, many years. If you need carbs for growth, then how are these kids thriving? How are they growing? How are they doing so well without the carbs? It's simple. It's a myth. You don't need carbs to grow. What you need is good blood sugar. What you need is to control your diabetes and tame your type 1. If you do that, you won't have to worry about stunted growth. You won't have to worry about all these other issues that comes from not managing your diabetes. So again, one more time, carbs, not essential for growth. What is essential is normal blood sugars. That is all, everyone. Keep taming that type 1 and keep being amazing. And of course, if you liked this video, if you liked me busting this myth for you today, please be sure to give this video a like, subscribe to the channel, subscribe to the page, and share it around the world so that way we can tell the world not only how we tame type 1, but how we bust away these myths that all the naysayers put on us. That's all for now. See you next time.